एटमॉस्फेरिक रिफ्रैक्शन। इन ऑर्डर टू अंडरस्टैंड द एटमॉस्फेरिक रिफ्रैक्शन, फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल अंडरस्टैंड द टर्म रिफ्रैक्शन। रिफ्रैक्शन इज नथिंग बट अ बेंडिंग ऑफ लाइट व्हेन लाइट इज मूविंग फ्रॉम वन मीडियम टू अनदर मीडियम। सो इन द एटमॉस्फेयर वी हैव टू मीडियम। Our first medium is itself a atmosphere and outside the atmosphere we have a vacuum. Atmosphere is optically denser than vacuum. So when light travel from vacuum to atmosphere or light entering from vacuum to atmosphere, it is bending towards the normal. Now let us understand the natural phenomena occurring due to atmospheric refraction. Our first natural phenomena is the sun appears 2 minutes before the actual sunrise and sun appears 2 minutes after the sunset. It means we can say that advance of the sunrise and delay of the sunset by 2 minutes. So before understanding this advance and delay, let us understand how a person able to see a sun. If we assume the earth is a sphere, or sphere in the front view we have a circle, and a person is standing on the circle, means on the surface of the earth, and from the observer eye there is a horizon. If the sun is above the horizon, then we can say that a person is able to see the sun, and if the sun is below the horizon, then we can say that the person is not able to see the sun. Now consider the first case when sun is just rising. It means now sun is below the horizon. If sun is below the horizon, now the person is not able to see the sun from theoretical point of view. Let us understand the actual scenario. When light is coming from sun to the observer eye, light moves from vacuum to atmosphere. When the light is moving from vacuum to atmosphere, vacuum is a optically rarer medium and atmosphere is optically denser medium. So light bends towards the normal. But our eye or person sees straight. When we extend this line, a person is able to see the sun which is above the horizon. So sun is actually not rising up, but the person able to see the sun 2 minutes before the actual sunrise. Similar to the sunrise case, we have another case, that is sunset. In sunset, the sun is below the horizon, but light from the sun moving from vacuum to atmosphere, so it is bending towards the normal, but our eye sees straight. When we extend this light, we get a sun above the horizon. The sun is actually below the horizon, but a person is able to see the sun because his reflection, or we can say that the refracted sun is above the horizon. So we can say that there is 2 minute delay in the sunset. Our next question is, why stars appear higher than their actual position? We know that stars are in the space, and in the space there is vacuum, and observer is on the earth surface, means in the atmosphere. So when the light is coming from vacuum to atmosphere, it is bending towards the normal, but our eye sees straight. So when we extend the line, we get the position of the star higher than their actual position. Our next question is, why stars twinkle at night? So before understanding the twinkling effect of stars, let us understand what is the meaning of twinkle. This bulb is actually twinkling. It means sometimes this bulb give bright light and sometimes this bulb give faint light. So this same effect is shown by stars. Now let us understand how the stars is able to show this effect. The stars are very far from the earth, so we considered the stars as a point sized. So when the light is coming from a point size to the observer eye through atmosphere, the observers see the twinkling effect of star. Why? Because in the atmosphere, our atmosphere is not steady. It means in the atmosphere there is wind and there is change in the temperature at each and every point. So our atmosphere is not steady. So sometimes the observer see the bright light of the star and sometimes the observer see the faint light. It means for the observer, star is showing the twinkling effect. Now our next question is, then why planets do not twinkle? So in order to understand why planets do not twinkle, let us understand why stars twinkle. We considered the stars as a point source because they are too far from us. But the planets are actually not too far from us. So we cannot consider the planet as a point source. It means in order to see the twinkling effect of the planet, we have to consider so many points on the planet. Now each and every point showing the twinkling effect. But the whole light is coming to the observer eye. So this whole bunch of light nullify the effect of twinkle. So that's why planets do not twinkle.